Hello and welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. We're going to dive out to our command line to learn a little bit about Orc. Often you really like the tutorials that we have on Orc, and we're going to be able to show you something really practical today by identifying duplicate files in our file system. Come on, let's see how we can put this to use. Hello and a big warm welcome to the command line of my Ubuntu system. But just because I'm using Ubuntu doesn't mean that you have to be using Ubuntu. It should work across any Linux distribution as we are looking at standard command line tools. Now I'm in the working directory here, and if I list it, we can see then we've got files of similar names, but we don't really know if they're duplicates. So we can go through and identify they are duplicates by doing an MD5 sum based on their content. So we use MD5 sum. As we go through and then look at asterisk, we can see then that host and host one are exactly the same file, and the two PDFs are exactly the same file, but host two is different to both hosts and host one. By checking the MD5 sum, we're looking at the file content and we're not going by the metadata. So the file name, the file and metadata can be separate, but the actual content is what we're checking with our MD5 sum. We can also go through and include other files from other directories. We don't just have to stick with this current working directory. So if I up arrow key and include the etc and host file, well, we can see by checking the checksum of it, it's AA, so it's the same as hosts and hosts one. So we know where we got that file from, but of course it's still different to hosts two. Now, whilst this is going to work for me at the command line on a small scale, on a larger scale with many files, it's not going to work. So we're going to have to send the output through to our command line tool, Orc, to do some of the heavy lifting for us. Now, with Orc, we can have three blocks of code, our begin block, our main block, and our end block. To begin with, we're just going to work with the main block, and this is what we normally see with Orc. So we open up in single quotes, our blocks are defined with brace brackets, and then we can go through and put the content of our brace brackets, and we want to go through and create an array. We're just going to call this count. And we're going to be adding then $1. $1 is our first field that's coming through. That's going to be the MD5 checksum. And we're going to be incrementing to it. So if we've got the same MD5, we're just adding to the array element. We can close off our brace brackets, close off our quotes, and then hit the big enter key. And you're going to say, Andrew, it didn't work. Well, it did. But all we've done is populate the array. We haven't printed the array. The array is just a multi-valued variable. So without printing out our variable, or in this case, the array, we're not actually going to see anything. But at least we've tested the code is working. We can up arrow key, and this is where we can start doing our heavy lifting within the end block. So we can put end and then our brace brackets. Our brace brackets are still there to define the start and the end of the block that we are naming end. And we're going to create a for loop, an iteration. We want to iterate through each element of our count array and populate a variable that we call k. Now, k doesn't exist at the moment. Count does, the array. But each time we iterate through count, we pull out the value and put it in k. So this is going to be able to help print our MD5 values, or at least the count to begin with. If I go through then and print count on then our K, hit the big enter key, we're going to be able to see files that have duplicates. So 2, 3, and 1. Obviously 1, we've only got one copy of that MD5 checksum, 3 copies and 2 copies. But we don't know what we're really talking about here because we haven't included the array entry itself, just the count. so we can go through and put a little bit more information in here, which will then give me the MD5 checksum. So let's up arrow key, go back into our print statement. And if we include here to print out the value of K, so K will be the MD5 checksum. And then to separate it from the actual count itself, we're going to put in then double quotes and colon and a space. When we look at the output now, we can see the MD5 checksum and then how many copies of each checksum we have. Now again, that's not really helping me too much from a human perspective because I don't know the checksum by looking at it. But we can go through and create ourselves another array and populate that array with the file name. And then we can choose to print out our file name. But maybe we only want to print out the file name based on there being at least two copies of the file. So as we go back, we go into our main block, putting a semicolon, that's the end of one line of code, putting in a second line where we're creating an array called name. And we're going to populate the entry with that, with our name and $1. So looking at the MD5 checksum and adding to it the file name. So $2, $1 is the checksum, $2 is the file name. That's the information that we're passing in from MD5 sum. I can hit enter on that, and of course we've only populated the name array. We haven't done any extra work within our end block. So we're not seeing any difference, but of course we can go through and up arrow key. I'm going to go back inside of my closing brace brackets and I'm going to remove the print statements that I have. And I'm going to change this through to an if statement. Because we only want to print something now if our count K, which we were printing before, is greater than 1. So we can go through and say if count K is greater than 1. So we've got duplicates. Our test condition, like the for loop, is all contained within our parentheses. So close off our parentheses. And then we go into our print statement. So we can then specify that we print our file name by looking up the value of K. And now we get to see our my PDF, the shared PDF, hosts, host one, and etc hosts. Notice we don't see host 2, the non-duplicate file. Now, like everything, it can seem a little bit complex, but play around with it yourself. I will also leave code examples in the description so you're able to download it for yourself to play.
All that is left to say is thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this, then you are probably sadder than I first thought. For more of this drivel, please subscribe, like and comment to @TheUrbanPenguin.